Dear guests from all over the world, dear Dr. McCobe, dear Professor Schlecht, dear Dr. Funk, dear colleagues, it's a pleasure to welcome you very warmly to the first Erich Fromm Research Conference in Berlin. It's a great honor for the International Psychoanalytic University to host this event in our city where Erich Fromm got his analytical training in the end of the 20s, living about 15 minutes from this place in Bayerischer Platz number 1 in Schöneberg. Personally, I met Erich Fromm in Berlin the day before yesterday, visiting the Anna Freud Schule, Anna Freud School. I found this poster. It's a very bad, I only had my iPhone with me, but I took it. It's a poster prepared by students in the hall of the school. It's about the life of Erich Fromm, and I think so he is still alive in this city. Our university, a non-profit organization based on a very generous donation, is a unique place of international scientific psychoanalysis. We are proud to have this conference, which provides a differentiated survey of the work of Erich Fromm and his contemporary developments. According to Erich Fromm, science means, quote, an attitude of objectivity. It is a human attitude to have the courage to examine whether the data that we gathered confirmed our idea or disproved it, and whether one had the courage to change a theory if the data showed that they had not proved it. And he observed that the average person has become the consumer of science and expect that the scientist knows it all. People are convinced that scientists are like priests, he said in the 50s. Scientists are like priests who have complete certainty about the world. There is somebody, at least, who has certainty and conviction, and one feels a sense of security oneself. Some 20 years later, Horst Eberhard Richter called this phenomenon Gottes complex, the complex of God. And Fromm goes on, the social sciences of today, impressed by the success and prestige of the natural sciences, try to apply the methods of the natural sciences to the furthering of mankind. Not only do they not ask themselves whether the method which is valid for the study of things is also valid for the study of man, but they even fail to question whether the concept of the scientific method is not naive and outdated. They believe that only a method that counts and weighs can be called scientific, forgetting that the most advanced natural sciences today, such as theoretical physics, operate with bold hypotheses based on imaginative inferences. There is a difference between the objective approach, in which the object is nothing but an object, and an approach in which the observer at the same time relates empathically to the persons he observes. End of quote. Fromm's understanding of science is very convergent with the mission state of the IPU, of our university. As all of you probably know, Fromm substituted Freud's drive theory by a theory of psychic need to be related to other individuals, to reality, to social groups. The historical situation is inscribed into the psyche of every individual. In accordance with Freud's studies of society and culture, Fromm's central appeal to psychoanalysts is not to neglect the identification of the individual with economic, social, cultural, and historical factors, and the meaning of its interchange with the development of the personality. The result is a second character. He called it social character, which makes people want to do what they have to do. I'm very eager to hear from the experts how this social character appears in our days. Thanks to the Erich Fromm Institute in Tübingen, the original version of Fromm's paper Psychoanalysis is now available. It was published recently in the Fromm Forum number 18, and it's available in the conference room where we meet tomorrow. In this paper, Fromm defines his own position in the field of psychoanalysis of 1955. He stresses his connection to Freud, saying the most important of Freud's findings have been accepted while not ignoring differences. Quote, there is a great deal of controversy about the content of what is so strongly repressed and so influential in man's life, end of quote. In this view, the polarity of Freud's late drive theory never found the same applications to clinical data as the earlier ones. In particular, Freud's understanding of man's destructiveness as an expression of the death drive is not shared by Fromm, as you know. Fromm believes that, quote, the basic inner forces which determine man's life are not his instinctual needs, but those which stem from the very nature and condition of human existence and its inherent contradictions, end of quote. He believes that these fundamental needs include the necessity for relatedness, rootedness, transcendence, creativity and destruction, sense of identity and frame of orientation and devotion. Quote, man is a freak of nature, lacking the instinctive equipment which regulates the life of all animals, but gifted instead with reason, imagination and self-awareness, life becomes for him a problem which must be solved. In the lifelong process of problem solving, mental health is, according to Erich Fromm, identical with the development of a productive orientation, the ability to grasp the world in the realm of feeling by love, in the realm of thought by critical and imaginative reason, and in the realm of action by creative work and art. Crucial conflicts arise between the inherent need for love, human solidarity, and the development of reason, on the one hand, and a society which does not satisfy these needs on the other. Fromm criticized the society, quote, stultifying and paralyzing man of transforming him into an automaton, into a marketing personality who loses the capacity for genuine and profound feeling and to think critically and to work actively. In my personal development, the reading of Fromm's The Art of Loving and To Have or To Be in the 60s and 70s was very important. Erich Fromm gave us as young students an example and a role model for an analyst not living in an ivory tower. We should not begin this conference without thanking Dr. Funk for preparing the conference with its rich program dealing with the widening spectrum of Fromm's work, to thank Professor Kechele for building the bridge between the Erich Fromm Society and the IPU, and last but not least, a very special thank to you, Professor Schlecht, for your generosity, which enables us to have this meeting. He himself will probably tell you something about his motivation for sponsoring the scientific work on Erich Fromm. Thank you very much.